Gary Fetter. I'm in the Department of Electrical and Computer Engineering at Carnegie Mellon. I also have a joint appointment within the Robotics Institute at Carnegie Mellon. My research is in microelectromechanical systems. It's called MEMS for short. And it's about making tiny sensors and actuators on integrated circuit chips. It's also about designing those types of sensors and actuators. Probably the area that most people think of first is in cell phones. There's a lot of interest in putting more sensors into those types of handheld systems and making them run at lower power. One of the most important examples that consumers see are, for example, accelerometers and to some extent gyroscopes inside of these cell phones, where if you tilt the phone, your image will tilt with that. That's all MEMS type of technology. A gyroscope is a sensor that detects rotation and orientation. One of the uses for these types of devices is for control of micro air vehicles, which are commonly called drones now. This type of device is needed in order to make sure the vehicle can stay stable in the air. And we take that kind of performance now for granted. For if you buy a hobby aircraft, you know, it just works. Well, that's because of those types of sensors. In our project, we're looking at pulling that performance to the next level, where we can start to look at personal navigation, where let's say you don't have a GPS type of tracking system on you, or you're in an environment where you might not be able to get that kind of service. With the proper type of inertial sensors, one could walk for hours and know where one is within a few feet. To get that kind of performance, what we're looking at is some of the external influences to the gyroscope operation, where having external stresses on the device, either due to temperature or because materials are aging with time or things are changing within the system that it's in, that changes the operation of the gyroscope. We're looking at instrumenting onto the gyroscope chip. So think of it as we're putting extra sensors on the sensor to be able to detect those types of influences and then compensate for them to make an even better device performance so that we can achieve these kind of personal navigation applications.